Welcome back to Candy's Art World. I'm Candy, and today we're going to be finishing up this painting. We're going to be adding the leaves and the elephants. Right now I'm mixing yellow and black to make an olive green for the leaves and the trees. Started with a darker green, and then I lighten the green and add highlights later. I'm adding in the highlights on the leaves. This piece was so much fun to do. I think total combined time to paint the whole thing was around 7 hours or so, if you take out the drying time, which isn't really bad for how big the painting is. But if you mix this, I had primary yellow and black, and I mixed it to make an olive green, and then I would add a little more yellow to lighten it up. But I would never have known that you mix yellow and black to make olive green. Tried to have as many different shades of green as possible to try to help add depth to it. The motion I was using is more of a dab, dab, dab for the leaves, not really a stroke. I used my pencil sharpener to sharpen a piece of regular school chalk to draw in the elephants. I drew in a mama elephant and a baby elephant. I just drew like the outline and mainly the ear shape. The rest I painted in. In the tusk, so for the mom, I tried to make sure I drew in the tusks too. also my tip when you're trying to draw something, instead of trying to draw the whole thing, look for shapes. If you look for shapes in your reference photo instead of the whole picture, it's easier to tackle. So instead of drawing an elephant, I drew the shape of the ear, shape of the head, stuff like that. Made it easier than trying to take on the whole elephant. And here I mixed black and titanium white. In different amounts. I tried to kind of go with painting in the darker areas of the mama elephant first. When you're painting something that's mostly one color, the shading becomes, well, the shading's always important, but when you're working with an object that's one color, you really want to get those tones and values in and try to help give it dimension. now I'm going back and forth between the lighter color and the mid-tone color. On the highlights on the ears, I was mixing mostly white with just a little bit of black. On this closer ear, I decided to be brave and just try to paint the eye in freehand instead of drawing it in first. I think it ended up coming out pretty good. Thank you. the other eye was a little bit more challenging. It was at an awkward angle. But that's what the picture looked like, so that's what I painted. Adding in the wrinkles to the trunk. I didn't want it to really look like just a bunch of lines, so I decided to blend it back out a little bit. I want it to look more like a texture and not just a bunch of lines. And with the tusks, instead of going straight white, I mixed a little gray, a very light shade of gray, to try to help give depth and dimension to the tusks. I put two little reflective dots in the mama elephant's eyes. Try to make it more dimensional. And here I'm putting in the mama's bottom part of her trunk that's wrapped around the baby. And for the baby, I decided to go with mostly lighter shades of gray, so that way it would stand out from the mama.
Thank you.
want to say a special thank you to my mom for reminding me that elephant tail ends have like little hairs. And then I forgot the baby tail. So I added the baby's tail. Every elephant needs a tail. Added a little shine to his eye, but it was a little big, so I had to go back in and fix the eye. But that's the good thing about acrylic paint. If you don't like the way something is, you can paint over it after it dries or blend it out. I really enjoyed putting detail in the ears of the elephants. I think that was my favorite part. And here I am using Payne's Gray and water to thin it out real thin to add shadows casting off the elephants and the trees. Some of the painting was a little out of frame. I hope you enjoyed watching. Please like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Have a great day.